As we approach the late spring and summer months, the threat for lightning greatly increases across Montana and Idaho. Being that we are in a part of the country that enjoys the great outdoors, there are times that we are all exposed to the danger of lightning. When people think of weather killers, things such as tornadoes and hurricanes commonly come to mind. However, lightning leads to an average of 54 deaths a year in the United States and is a factor that should never be ignored. We are hoping this short video will help to educate about the dangers of lightning and provide some guidance on how to minimize the likelihood of injury or death from lightning. First things first, what causes lightning? Understanding the signs of lightning is just the first step to understanding why it's so important to get to a safe place anytime thunderstorms are in the area. If you can hear thunder, even a distant rumble or a crackling aloft, you are already in danger of becoming a lightning victim. Immediate actions and proper planning can greatly reduce your chances of becoming a lightning victim. With rare exception, such as volcanic eruptions and large forest fires, virtually all lightning is produced by thunderstorms. In simple terms, lightning is a giant spark of electricity in the atmosphere, or between the atmosphere and the ground. In order to have lightning, a charge separation must exist between a cloud and the surface of Earth. Mother Nature does not like to be out of balance, and thus lightning is the response to this charge separation. Ice is a key component to lightning, and thus lightning occurs only in clouds that extend above the freezing level. As bits of ice within the cloud collide, friction results in an electrical charge, which builds up over time. Typically, a negative charge ends up concentrated at the bottom of the cloud, and since opposites attract, a positive charge builds at the surface. The ground's electrical charge tends to concentrate on things that stand up, such as mountains, trees, or even people. The charge streaming up from these higher points will eventually connect with the charge from the cloud, and a lightning strike is born. The massive amount of heat generated from the lightning bolt, in excess of 50,000 degrees Fahrenheit, causes the air to expand rapidly, resulting in thunder. Air is generally a poor conductor of electricity, normally preventing charges from moving freely through the atmosphere. However, if the charge difference between the cloud and the ground becomes too large, the insulating capacity of the air starts to break down and the air starts to ionize. This breakdown occurs on a molecular level and allows negative charges to start moving more freely in what is called a step leader. The actual lightning stroke is preceded by the step leader, which makes a rapid and staggered advance of negatively charged air from the base of the cloud. When the step leader approaches the ground, a spark surges upward from the ground towards the step leader. When the two connect, a pathway is created for the flow of electricity, which initiates a series of brightly illuminated strokes. Because individual strokes occur in rapid succession, lightning appears to flicker and flash. This video demonstrates what a lightning strike looks like in slow motion. Although the video is about 30 seconds long, the depicted lightning strike actually occurs in only a fraction of a second. Montana averages 356,911 cloud-to-ground lightning strikes every year. When averaging this out over the entire state of Montana, this equates to roughly 2.4 cloud-to-ground lightning strikes per square mile every year. Idaho averages 82,761 cloud-to-ground lightning strikes per year, which is roughly one cloud-to-ground lightning strike for every square mile each year. From 2002 to 2011, three deaths were reported in Montana and two in Idaho, resulting directly from lightning. Although when compared to the national average, Montana and Idaho have relatively few reported deaths, if you weight these deaths by the population of each state, Montana ranks in the top 10 for lightning fatalities, and Idaho ranks in the top 20. This is largely due to our small populations, but can also be partially attributed to our outdoor living culture, which leaves many people exposed to the elements each year. There are a lot of myths that surround lightning. Part of lightning education is understanding the truths about lightning. How many of these have you heard before? Myth number one, lightning never strikes the same place twice. In fact, lightning often strikes the same place repeatedly, especially if it's a tall or isolated object. The Empire State Building gets hit nearly 100 times a year. Higher terrains, such as mountain peaks, are also a frequent target for lightning. Myth number two, if it's not raining or there aren't clouds overhead, you're safe from lightning. This is not true. The fact is, lightning often strikes more than 3 miles from the center of a thunderstorm, far outside the thunderstorm cloud. In fact, bolts can strike as much as 10 to 15 miles from a thunderstorm. If you can hear thunder, lightning is within striking distance. As the saying goes, when thunder roars, go indoors. Once in a safe location, it is recommended you stay there for 30 minutes after you hear the last roar of thunder. Myth number three, rubber tires on a car protect you from lightning by insulating you from the ground. This is a common myth, which is in fact not true. The truth is, most cars are safe from lightning, but it is the metal roof and sides that protect you, not the rubber tires. Remember, convertibles, motorcycles, bicycles, open-shelled outdoor recreational vehicles, and cars with fiberglass shells offer no protection from lightning. When lightning strikes a vehicle, it goes through the metal frame into the ground. Don't lean on doors during a thunderstorm. Myth number four, a lightning victim is electrified. If you touch them, you will also be electrocuted. And this is, again, not true. The fact is, the human body does not store electricity. It is perfectly safe to touch a lightning victim to give them first aid. Cardiac arrest is the immediate cause of death for those who die from lightning strikes. However, some deaths can be prevented if the victim receives the proper first aid immediately. If someone is struck, call for help by dialing 911. If the victim is unresponsive or not breathing, begin CPR or use an automatic external defibrillator, AED, if one is available. If possible, move the victim to a safer place. Lightning can strike twice. Although only about 10% of people who are struck by lightning are killed, the other 90% often suffer from various degrees of disability. A few side effects from lightning strikes include short-term memory loss, difficulty with multitasking, slowed reaction time, irritability, personality change, forgetfulness, intense headaches, ringing in the ears, dizziness, nausea and vomiting, and difficulty sleeping. Myth number five, if outside in a thunderstorm, you should seek shelter under a tree to stay dry. Again, this is not true. The fact is, being underneath a tree is the second leading cause of lightning casualties. Lightning is attracted to tall objects, particularly when they are isolated. As tempting as it may be to take shelter from the rain under a tree, this is not a good course of action. Myth six, if trapped outside and lightning is about to strike, you should lay flat on the ground. The fact is, laying flat increases your chance of being affected by potentially deadly ground current. If you are caught outside in a thunderstorm, you should keep moving towards a safe shelter. If you cannot reach safe shelter, use the lightning crouch position, which is pictured here. By making yourself as small as possible and minimizing your contact with the ground, you will decrease the likelihood of being affected by a lightning strike. So what should you do when a thunderstorm approaches? If you are inside an enclosed building, you should be relatively safe from a lightning strike. However, with a few added precautions, you will further increase your safety. It is wise to stay off corded telephones. Electricity can travel through the wiring in your home if it is struck. There have been reports of individuals being struck while talking on the telephone. Cell phones, however, are safe. Likewise, don't touch electrical equipment or cords during a lightning storm. Avoid plumbing. Activities such as doing the dishes or taking a shower should be avoided. Stay away from windows, doors, and concrete walls, which could leave you exposed to the current. What should you do if you are outside when a thunderstorm approaches? The best option is to plan ahead. Monitor the weather forecast for thunderstorms and consider postponing activities to avoid being caught in a dangerous situation. If you do continue on with your plans, know where you will go and how long it will take to get there if threatening weather emerges. Make sure to monitor the weather while you are outside. Look for signs of a developing thunderstorm, such as darkening skies, flashes of lightning, or increased winds. Remember, no place outside is safe from lightning. If you hear thunder, lightning is close enough to strike. Immediately move to an indoor shelter, such as an enclosed building or a car with a metal roof. Once you are in a safe shelter, stay there until 30 minutes after you hear the last clap of thunder. If you are caught outside with no safe shelter anywhere nearby, the following actions may reduce your risk. Immediately get off elevated areas such as hills, mountain ridges, or peaks. Avoid open areas. Don't be the tallest object around. Never lay flat on the ground. Use the lightning crouch position demonstrated earlier. Never use a tree, cliff, or rocky overhang for shelter. Immediately get out and away from ponds, lakes, and other bodies of water. Stay away from objects that conduct electricity, such as barbed wire fences, power lines, windmills, etc. Thank you for listening to this brief presentation on lightning safety. We hope you keep these safety tips in mind as we move into the spring and summer months and begin enjoying the great outdoors. Stay safe out there, and please remember, when thunder roars, go indoors.